Hey guys, it's Mike Akuma here. In today's video, I want to introduce you to CAROL, a reduced exertion, high intensity interval training bike that uses artificial intelligence. What makes CAROL unique is that its signature workout takes only 8 minutes and 40 seconds to complete, including two 20-second sprints. Despite that short workout duration, CAROL has the same benefits as much longer workouts, and studies have shown that riding CAROL for only 3 times a week for a total of 26 minutes of workout provides the same benefits as going for a run 5 times a week for 30 to 45 minutes. In fact, riding CAROL 3 times a week improves your cardiorespiratory fitness as measured by VO2max, increases your HDL cholesterol, the good cholesterol, decreases your triglycerides, lowers your blood pressure and your blood sugar. I've had CAROL for over 2 years, and since I started riding CAROL, I've improved my VO2max by 28% and my peak power input by a whopping 37%. Those are incredible numbers, and I'm gonna tell you exactly how I've been using CAROL, what the bike can do, what's the science behind CAROL. I also have a couple of in-depth blog posts that link and reference those scientific studies. So if you wanna check them out, look at the description below. All of that is linked down there. I also link a couple of other YouTube videos that I previously published on CAROL that compares CAROL with a Peloton or some of the other spinning bikes that you might be familiar with. So I definitely recommend to check that out. I'm also gonna show you how it looks like and feels like to ride CAROL. So I did a demo ride the day before recording this video, so you're gonna see the sprint, you're gonna see exactly how intense it is and how much it sucks the life out of me, so you can get a feel that this is the real deal. So stick with me, I'm gonna show you all of that, and then we'll dissect it right so you can find out exactly how it works, why it works, and why CAROL is so effective in comparison to much, much longer workouts. Now before we dive in, make sure you subscribe to this channel and you click on the little alert button so you get notified when I publish more videos like this. Now CAROL calls this workout the intense workout because A, it is intense, but it's also a reduced exertion, high intensity interval training type of workout. So let's talk about REHIT for a moment and let's see how it compares to traditional high intensity interval trainings. So I normally do CrossFit, and most people would consider CrossFit a HIIT type of workout, a high intensity interval training type of workout. And the important difference between HIIT and REHIT is that a REHIT type of workout reduces the time you have to exert yourself, hence reduced exertion, but it takes the intensity up a notch. So it's more intense, but it takes less time. And that's what makes CAROL so effective. And again, I've linked to all the scientific evidence that explain why REHIT works and why it's so effective in my blog post, so check that out if you wanna find out more. But the intense workout, the 8 minutes and 40 seconds, is a classic REHIT workout. And the way it's set up is you have a 2 minute warm up. So you just sit on the bike and you casually paddle for 2 minutes just to get your blood flowing, but not to increase your heart rate. Your heart rate should be fairly low. And then at the end of those 2 minutes, you go into an all out 20 second sprint. You're gonna see that in the demo video in a moment. And after the 20 second sprint, you do a 3 minute recovery ride. So again, very slow, very casual. You wanna reduce your heart rate, you wanna bring it all the way back down almost to baseline, and you keep going for 3 minutes, and then you repeat another sprint. Another 20 seconds of all out, all you can do. And after those 20 seconds, you have a 3 minute cool down and you are done. So all in all, 8 minutes and 40 seconds. The 8 minutes consisting of 2 minutes of warm up, 3 minutes recovery, 3 minutes cool down, and then 2 times 20, 40 seconds of actual work. And I know this sounds unbelievable that you can get a good workout in reality, 40 seconds of work, because the 8 minutes are just, you know, warm up, recovery, and cool down. There's not really any effort you have to put into these. So this is the first workout, or the workout that I recommend you do on CAROL. And it's the one that I'm gonna show you in the demo video next. So let's look into the demo video. Let's see how it is to ride CAROL, how intense it is, And then we're gonna dissect it, right? And I'm gonna explain you what happened during those sprints, what happened in your body from a cardiovascular perspective, from a signaling perspective, and why it's so effective. So let's check it out. So we're gonna start with the intense sprint. That's the 8 minutes and 40 seconds workout. And for 2 minutes, we're just gonna do a warm up. Very slow, very paced. We wanna make sure our heart rate stays down, definitely in the blue zone. We wanna make sure that the watts, the power input stays down under 20. You can see it here also in the, with that graph here, we wanna stay in the blue. And we're just gonna warm up. The point here is, once this counter goes down to 3, 2, 1, and the screen turns red, that we go from 0 to 100. And that's really what it takes to shock the body into that fight or flight response. That's the secret sauce of CAROL, in combination, of course, with the AI-powered resistance adjustment that happens on the fly based on how much power you put in, all of that good stuff. But the important part is to go from 0 to 100, to shock the body. That's what it takes to start depleting glycogen and triggering some of those metabolic pathways that we'll talk throughout this video. And I can tell you, I've done dozens of rides on CAROL, but still, every single time that countdown goes down and starts, you know, the 3, 2, 1, I get sweaty palms because I know what's gonna come. I know it's gonna hurt for a little bit, for only 20 seconds, but it's still 20 seconds of hurt. All right, got 15 more seconds. Sprint is coming up. Gonna get in the right mental mindset to go all in, as if our life depended on it. Absolutely brutal. I know it's only 20 seconds, but it's brutal. But now we have a 3 minute recovery where we're gonna try to control our breathing, get the heart rate back down into the blue, and then do it again. And I just noticed, I just obliterated my previous personal best. I just scored 1,469 watts of power input. And that's after a day of heavy squatting. I squatted yesterday, my legs are a little sore. The reason why we do a second sprint is not to make it extra painful, but to trick the nervous system into thinking there might be more of those sprints coming. Because for the nervous system, it's the same response as if there was a threat, a life-threatening, I don't know, saber-toothed tiger trying to attack us. And so for the nervous system, that's it's the same as this sprint. It was all out. Suddenly the body has huge energy demands and it gets ready for battle. And then we do it again. And so the nervous system thinks, ooh, we might not be out of danger yet. Let's remain ramped up. And that's what helps with the afterburn, with burning calories even long after you got off the bike. And that's one of the things that makes this workout so incredibly beneficial, especially in comparison with longer workouts. All right, we got 20 more seconds. And now the second sprint is a little bit more sticky than the first one because my legs are already partially depleted, but we're gonna do it again. Holy moly. This ain't no joke. You know, I consider myself relatively fit. But this bike sucks the life out of me every single time. And the fitter I get, the harder Carol gets. It learns, it adjusts, and it makes sure you always get the maximum benefits out of each single ride. So you can't plateau. You can't outright this bike. But now it's over. I have 1.5 minutes more of cooldown, and it's done. That was less than 9 minutes. Yeah, I'm a little wasted. That's the point of it. But I'm not sweat soaked. I mean, I can feel, you know, I'm getting warm for sure, but I could just throw on a shirt now, go to the office. Don't have to take a shower. I only spent 9 minutes. Could have been my lunch break, you know? And so once I've caught my breath and I'm off this bike, I'm gonna explain you step by step what happened here during the ride. Not necessarily to my face, but what happened inside of my body. What chemical reactions took place that ultimately make me fitter and improve my cardiorespiratory fitness in the same manner as going for a 45-minute run or doing some other prolonged exercise, maybe spinning for an hour. All of that in less than 9 minutes, 3 times a week. I'll walk you through it, you'll see. Whew. Oh yeah, peak power, that's right. Man, that was an intense workout. I'm sure you could see it. I mean, it, just looking at the screen recording, you see, you know, my heart rate, you see my power input, you see the RPM, how fast I was paddling. You can see a clear difference between the warm-up and then the sprint, and then from the recovery again to the sprint. So what happened there? Why is this working, and why can you not simply replicate a workout like this on another spinning bike? So let's talk about this. Let's first talk about what's going on inside of your body during those sprints. So when you do the warm-up, you know, you basically, there is nothing really happening. You're not burning a ton of calories. There is not really anything going on. But by going from 0 to 100, by going all out on that first sprint, what happens is that you significantly increase your body's energy demands by 10,000%. You literally go from 0 almost to 10,000. And when that happens, the body tries to make energy available by depleting your muscle glycogen stores. So during those first 10 seconds of the sprint, you deplete between 25 and 30% of your muscle glycogen. Glycogen is the storage mechanism of glucose. So by releasing glycogen, your body makes rapid energy available for your muscles to do their work and to do their job. The other thing that happens during that sprint is your sympathetic nervous system gets upregulated. So you basically shock your body into a fight or flight response. And I always like to compare the sprints on Carol with, you know, you just walking, taking a casual stroll, and suddenly an animal jumps out and tries to attack you. and the fight or flight response that you're experiencing in that particular moment goes back to millions of years. I mean, that's how humans have evolved. Imagine a Neanderthal dude, you know, just walking around, you know, looking for food, maybe looking for berries to collect, and suddenly a saber-toothed tiger jumps out and tries to attack him. So at that point, you basically have two options. You either run away, flight, or you fight. And in either case, you need rapid, immediate energy to either run away or to get into the fight. And that's what the body is doing. So during those first 10 seconds, you literally trigger a fight or flight response. And the body reacts accordingly, making energy available in the form of glycogen. During the second 10 seconds, the second part of that sprint, certain signaling molecules get released, like MPK, like PGC1-alpha. Those are the molecules that, once activated, cause your body to make more mitochondria. Mitochondria are the power plants in your cells. The more you have and the stronger they are, the more energy you can produce and the fitter you become. So as you increase the number of mitochondria and the strength of the mitochondria, the fitter you get. It's as simple as that. And so during the second half of the 20-second sprint, your body starts releasing those signaling molecules. And then suddenly, you know, you go back into a recovery. You go back to paddling slow and your body thinks, okay, danger averted, everything is good, we're fine. We don't really have to do anything. We made the energy available. We can, you know, use it now or reabsorb it and we're good to go. And 3 minutes later, you go into that sprint again. You shock your body again into, or your nervous system in particular, into that fight or flight response. And at this point, the body starts activating those signaling molecules, making more mitochondria, increasing the strength of their existing mitochondria. Because the nervous system at this point thinks, okay, this happened twice now. It might happen again. So we have to prepare. We have to become stronger to fight the next fight or to run away again, whatever the case might be. So this is, at the end of the day, a biohack. You hack your body into thinking there is danger and we need to adapt to the danger by becoming stronger. This is what happens during those two sprints. And then the sprint is over and you recover and you get off the bike. But because you're so ramped up, because your body is still thinking there might be another threat around the corner, it remains ramped up and it keeps burning calories and making energy available. And that's what causes the afterburn effect. So as you get off the bike, you keep actively burning calories that you otherwise during a regular workout wouldn't. Once the workout is over and you slow down, you know, you stop burning calories. With Carol, there is an afterburn. You keep burning calories because your body remains in high alert, so to say, expecting another attack from a saber-toothed tiger. So at this point you might think, well, you know, I just, you know, get on a regular spinning bike or my Peloton or what have you, and, you know, I'm gonna sprint for 20 seconds twice and it's the same thing. It's not exactly the same thing. I'm not arguing or saying that you cannot get the same overall benefits with any other type of workout, being running, jogging, CrossFit, regular spinning bikes, anything. As long as you move long enough, you'll eventually get to those benefits. I can tell you, whenever I do a CrossFit workout, I dump massive amounts of glycogen. I can see it. I'm wearing a continuous glucose monitor on and off, and I can tell whenever I do an intense CrossFit workout, my blood sugar spikes because my body depletes glycogen to make energy available. I get the same effects, but those workouts take 45 minutes or an hour. And that's really the big difference. And in regards to replicating that type of workout on a regular spinning bike, the reason why you cannot do this is because, as you might have seen during the demo, while I was riding, I did not adjust the resistance at all. I didn't have to because the bike is doing it for me. And if you look closely at the RPM meter there, it shows you, you know, how I ramped up from, I don't know, maybe 30 RPM or so to, I don't know, 200, I don't even know what the exact number was, but it went up significantly and very fast, like almost instantaneously. And the reason for that is that when I start the sprint on Caro, there is no resistance whatsoever. I just go as fast as my muscle fibers can twitch. It's really high intensity, all in, no resistance whatsoever. But as I keep going, especially around maybe the 10 second mark, Caro starts dynamically adjusting the resistance to make it harder. So as I fatigue, the bike actually increases the resistance, making that sprint even more intense during the second part of that first 20 seconds. And then during the second sprint, you can really show see my RPM going down because the resistance becomes almost unbearable. It's like pedaling in mud. It's, you know, you put all in and nothing is moving. And that dynamic adjustment happens based on what Carol feels is the most appropriate resistance to get the maximum benefits out of the ride. So it not only monitors how much power I put in, how fast I can go, it also takes previous rides into account to see if I have improved my energy input, if I have gotten fitter, and if so, the bike is gonna change the resistance for the next time. So Carol learns from not only how much power you put in during previous rides, but even during the ride, it adjusts it based on a very specific protocol that has been shown in scientific studies to produce the most benefits in the shortest amount of time. And you cannot reproduce this on a regular bike because there is no way you can keep adjusting the resistance manually as you ride the bike in an all-out sprint. There is just no way. That's what Carol at the end of the day does. That's the secret sauce, if you will, of that AI-powered bike. It uses artificial intelligence to figure out what is the best resistance for each segment of those two sprints to get the most benefits out of the bike. And that's how Carol is different. So yes, you can get the same benefits in terms of improving your cardiorespiratory fitness, you know, blood pressure, your blood lipid markers, etc., with any other type of workout. It's just gonna take you significantly longer. With Carol, all it takes me is 8 minutes and 40 seconds, and out of those 8 minutes and 40 seconds, it's only 40 seconds of actual work. There is no excuse, no excuses, to not hop on the bike and do it at least 3 times a week. In fact, when I recorded the demo video and I actually achieved a PR, a personal record in terms of peak power input during that very ride, I'm very proud of that. I did this right after having a large meal and a day after doing heavy squats in the gym. So my legs were sore, my stomach was full, and I knew that I wanted to ride Carol, not only for this video, because I tried to do it every day. I could do it because not the full stomach and not the sore legs prevented me from doing 40 seconds of work. There should not be any excuse why you cannot ride Carol at least 3 times a week, and that's all it takes. 26 minutes per week of time investment to get fitter from a cardiovascular perspective. There is no excuse, you know? Everyone can do that, and you can do that too. And one of the other side effects, positive side effects, of doing a workout that's so short, or that's intensity is so short and reduced, that you don't really sweat a whole lot. I mean, I got warm, and mostly because I have a lot of lights here in the studio, so that contributed to me heating up. I'm actually hot right now, just being in front of the light, I'm not doing anything. But on a regular ride with Carol, without all the lighting here around, you don't sweat. You don't have to jump into a shower after a ride. You can do this in your lunch break, you know? You don't have to take a shower and, you know, change of clothes, etc. None of that applies to Carol. You can do it anytime using whatever you're wearing. You don't have to change, you don't have to get into gym clothes, and do that ride. 9 minutes, less than 9 minutes is all it takes. All right, so that was the signature workout. That's really the one that I do on most days. But that's not the only workout you can do on Carol. There are several others. There is an energizer ride, and that is similar to the intense ride, but it contains only 2 10-second sprints. So you get the benefits of the glycogen depletion, but not necessarily all the same benefits as far as your signaling molecules are concerned, you know, MPK, PGC1, alpha, etc. So it's slightly less effective, but it's only 10 seconds. I do this when I'm, you know, really not feeling like working out, when I'm, maybe I didn't sleep well, whatever the case might be, just to energize myself. You know, I jump on the bike, I do the 10 second sprints, and then I feel much better afterwards. So that's another type of workout Carol offers. And then there are a couple of fat burning workouts that are geared towards burning more calories and burning more fat. Because, for example, the intense workout, the 8 minutes and 40 seconds, I burn approximately 250 calories per workout, and that includes the afterburn. So the bike calculates your afterburn. My watch, if I, you know, used my Apple Watch or my Whoop Strap or whatever, it would show a smaller calorie burn but that's because neither of these devices take the afterburn into effect. The bike does it. So whatever you see on the screen, that's your total calorie burn for that session. And while 250 calories for 40 seconds of actual work is pretty significant, I would say, there are other workouts that burn even more calories, and the more calories you burn, the more fat calories you burn. So there is a fat burn 30 and a fat burn 60 workout. And the 30 and 60 stand for the number of sprints that you do during that workout. So they are much longer workouts. They're not quite as intense, but they are like, you know, 30 or 60 shorter sprints over a period of, I don't know, 15 to 20 or so minutes. So you spend more time on the bike, you sweat at that point, obviously, you burn more calories and you burn more fat. So if fat loss or weight loss is your primary goal and not necessarily becoming fitter from a cardiovascular and cardiorespiratory perspective, then those fat burn rides are a good way to go. Now, I would still recommend that if you wanna burn fat, I would do some of those shorter sprints, the intense workouts, at least two times, maybe three times a week, and then just supplement those with some of those fat burning workouts. I would not necessarily cut out or circumvent the intense sprints altogether, because the fitter you get, the more calories you burn in the long run, because the more you can put in, the more active you might be in other areas of your life. So that's just my personal recommendation. So there is a constant power workout where, you know, you set the power that you want to have and then the bike adjusts the resistance, and so you can just, you know, do like a regular type of spinning workout, if you will. There is a continuous ramp up program, and that's really the program you want to use if you want to measure your VO2 max. If you've done it before, measuring your VO2 max requires you to wear a mask, you know, to measure the oxygen you inhale, the CO2 you exhale, etc. And there is a specific protocol in place to get there, and that's a constant ramp up. So Carol has that built in as well. So if you want to do a true VO2 max test and you have the equipment, you can use that workout. And then there is the free ride option. And the free ride is, as the name implies, you just, you know, you can adjust the resistance, you can adjust everything that you can adjust on a regular spinning bike, and just go for a ride. There is even a Peloton app on Carol that you can use if you want to participate in Peloton classes. So if you have a Peloton membership, but you want to use Carol predominantly, and but from time to time you want to, you know, go for a 45 minute or an hour spin class or something because you like the instructor or whatever the case might be, you can do that. You can also use the free ride to participate in Apple Fitness Plus sessions. So my wife does Apple Fitness Plus, mostly yoga and those kind of workouts. But if you want to do it as part of a bike ride, you can do that as well. Not a problem. So these are, you know, all the workouts that Carol has. It's the intense, it's the energizer, it's the two fat burn, the fat burn 30 and the fat burn 60. It's the constant power, continuous ramp up, and the free ride. So let's talk about the bike hard and software. We haven't covered that at all, but the bike, as I'm sure you figured out by now, is a stationary bike. It has a commercial grade frame, so it's heavy duty. You cannot possibly break that bike. Everything is super solid and commercial grade. It uses standard parts, so if you want to replace the seat, you can certainly do so. For a while I had my personal bike seat on there before I switched it back. You can change the paddles, you can obviously use biking shoes, or it has the, you know, the cages as well. If you just want to use regular shoes like tennis shoes, you can, you know, use the cages and, you know, strap them in. You can use your, you know, biking shoes. So far I have not used biking shoes with Carol, but I just ordered a pair to see if that would even further increase my score on Carol. But everything is pretty standard. The screen is a tablet running Android. So if you're used to operating a tablet, be it an iPad or an Android, you'll feel right at home with Carol. There is only one app, the Carol app, that you have to launch, or that typically once you've, you know, launched it, it starts automatically, or it's automatically on the screen. You can have multiple users on Carol. It supports up to 8 users, at least the consumer version of Carol. If you want to do the commercial version, if you own a fitness center or something, you can have more users log into the bike. But again, standard Android tablet, you connect it to Wi-Fi. The bike is then also connected to the Carol Cloud subscription, or to the cloud account, where it stores all of your information, where you can get the global leaderboard. You can see how you fare, you know, in different metrics. You can see what your, you know, peak power output is, what your octane score is. That's Carol's proxy metric for VO2 max, since, you know, a regular user is not gonna wear a mask with every right to calculate their VO2max. Carol uses the octane score. It's a number that Carol calculates based on your heart rate during the sprints and your power input. And studies have shown that as your octane score improves, your VO2max improves at the same rate. So it's a very good proxy metric that tells you if your octane score is improving, then your VO2max has likely improved at the same rate. In my case, I've told you before, since I started riding Carol, I had an octane score of 38.5, I believe. And then my last one was 48.5 or so. So I had an improvement of 28% of my octane score. And that translates again to the similar improvement on VO2max. So you can see that in the app. You can see your power per pound of body weight, because obviously someone who is more body weight, more be it muscles or otherwise, is likely to be able to generate more power than someone who weighs less. So you can get it equalized or broken down by a pound of body weight, and different other metrics that you can see how you fare either in your local gym, in your local environment, or globally within, you know, your gender, and etc., etc. So it's a very nice way of, you know, having a friendly competition with others to see how you rank, how you improve, etc. Of course, you can see all of your own metrics. You can see a graph, how much you've improved. You get feedback after every ride. So Carol tells you, hey, great job. You know, you've had new peak power or a new octane score, etc. So you can see all of that in the app. You can see a history of all of your rides, etc., etc. So it's a very nice and intuitive app that you can have both on your phone. So I have on iOS, I have a version, but the tablet basically offers the same capability. And then there's a web interface. So if you're in front of a computer, you can log in and you can see all of that information as well. So let's talk about pricing. Carol costs $2,395 as of this recording in the United States. There might be different pricing in the different regions. The bike ships globally. So wherever you are, chances are you can get Carol delivered to your home. There are a couple of considerations. I'm gonna put all of that down in the description because those things might change over time and I wanna make sure, you know, I keep it up to date. But as of right now, I have a discount code down in the description. If you use that, you get a discount of Carol. There is also the ability to pay every month for Carol. Instead of having a one-time payment, you can break it up and pay every month for 12 months, interest-free. There are different money back guarantees that Carol offers. Right now, you can get the bike and within 100 days, you can return it if you don't like it. Honestly, I think that once you have started riding Carol and you see the benefits, you see how little time it really takes to get a great workout in and to become fitter and to improve your cardio, you're gonna keep that bike. I'm convinced. I've had it for 2.5 years now and I love it. So all of that down in the description, all the details, but again, $2,395, so $2,400. Give or take is what one bike costs. There are different options, different packages. So if you want to get like a floor mat, a bottle holder, extended warranty, all of that stuff, you can get that as an option, as an upgrade basically. The floor mat to protect the floor from sweat, etc., you won't need for the short sprints, but if you do the fat burn ones or the free ride where you sit on the bike longer and you start sweating, then that's, you know, a good way to protect the floor, especially if you have maybe, you know, hardwood like we have here in this room where I ride Carol most of the time. And so that's a good option. But at the end of the day, you know, if you just get the basic package, I think that's an excellent choice and it gets you everything you need to become fitter. Now, one thing that's that I get asked a lot is, you know, but I'm not super fit. You know, does it make sense for me to get Carol? And the good news is that regardless of your level of fitness, you can benefit from Carol. If you're not fit at all, if you've never worked out in your life, Carol is an excellent way to get started for several reasons. First of all, it's much, much better than going for a run, going jogging and doing some of the other more impact type or high intensity exercises, because, you know, riding a bike is very gentle on your joints, your knees, etc. Going for a run, not so much. That's why I don't really like running a lot. But regardless, if you're not fit at all, you'll get fitter by doing Carol. The most important thing when you ride Carol is to put in as much energy as you possibly can. So it doesn't matter in absolute numbers what your power input is. It depends on how much power you put in based on your capabilities at that particular moment. And as you improve, Carol improves with you, meaning that it learns from what you can do and it's gonna make it a little bit harder the next time you ride, etc., etc. So you cannot possibly outride or outperform the bike. I consider myself to be relatively fit, and as you've seen in a demo video, it sucks the life out of me. And I won't be able at any point in time to out outride that bike. I'm not ever gonna become fitter. If you take a professional cyclist and put him on Carol, that person is gonna suffer as much as you who might have never worked out a day in your life. You know, it doesn't really matter how fit you are. As long as you have the physical ability to sit on a bike and pedal, you're good to go. You can benefit from Carol and you will get stronger. Just make sure that when you do those sprints, you literally go all in. If you hold back, if you don't give it your all, then your benefits are gonna be reduced. That's very important to understand. Give it your all. Go as fast and as hard as you possibly can and you'll get the benefits. So let's talk about some of the frequently asked questions that I've gotten. First one is, how difficult is it to assemble Carol? And it's really, really simple. It took me maybe 30 minutes or less. You get the frame pretty much pre-assembled. The only thing you have to do is put on the seat, screw in the paddles, put in the handlebar and the tablet, connect the wires, and that is pretty much it. If you can use a screwdriver or a hex wrench or something, you can put together Carol. If you don't feel comfortable at all, Carol offers a service where they come in and put it together for you, so that's always an option. But if you're somewhat handy and know around your way, you know, with a hex or Allen wrench or whatever it is, you'll be perfectly fine putting it together in just a few minutes. Second question, where can you try Carol? Now, if you go to thecarolbike.com or carolbike.com and click on the showroom finder on the bottom, I think it is in the footer, you put in your zip code and then you get a list of gyms and other locations where you can go in and give Carol a try. See how it is, see how you like it. The other option, if you happen to live in the northern or in the North Metro Atlanta area or in the Milton Alpharetta area and you don't find anything around and you absolutely want to give it a try before making a purchase decision, shoot me an email, go to michaelkummer.com, click on contact, shoot me an email, and maybe we can figure something out that you can come over here and hop on my bike and see how it is. Next question I've gotten a lot is, can Carol help me with building muscles? And no, not necessarily, because especially with a 8 minutes, 20, 40 seconds workout, you're on a bike for such a short amount of time that you don't really build a whole lot of muscles. Carol is meant as your cardio workout. It's meant to improve your cardiovascular and cardiorespiratory fitness. It's your cardio tool, basically, not necessarily your strength tool. So it doesn't replace lifting heavy weights, doing squats, deadlifts, all of that good stuff that I highly recommend you do as well. That's not what Carol does, but the cardio aspect of it, that's what the bike does very well. So, as I've mentioned before, I do CrossFit, and CrossFit is a combination of metabolic conditioning, cardio, as well as strength. I still do CrossFit 4 to 5 times a week to improve my strength, to improve my, you know, cardio under heavy loads, if you will. But just from a pure cardio perspective, to make me be able to go longer, to go faster for longer, that's why I do Carol. That's why I ride Carol 4 or 5 times a week as well, to improve my cardio, to improve my ability to sustain a higher heart rate, you know, and that's what Carol is. So not for strength, but for cardio. That's what Carol can do. And then that leads us to the next question. Well, if I run marathons or do triathlons, can I use Carol as my cardio workout? Carol doesn't replace running. If you compete in a running type of competition, you have to run. You have to practice that particular skill that happens to be running in your case. So you cannot not go run at all anymore and just use Carol. It's not gonna work, but Carol can help you to supplement your cardio, to make you fitter overall while you practice that particular skill that happens to be running in the case of a marathon or if you're a swimmer. So there are a lot of athletes that use Carol to complement their workouts, to make them fitter from a cardiovascular perspective overall, but that doesn't mean you cannot neglect practicing your particular skill, if that makes sense. All right, last question related to heart rate monitoring. So Carol has a heart rate monitor built into the handlebar. So as long as you have at least one hand, ideally two hands on the handlebar, it records your heart rate and it does it fairly accurately. But if you want to use a third party chest strap, like a Bluetooth connected heart rate monitor, you can certainly do that. Carol, I think, sells one, but you can use any third party heart rate monitor and then simply link it via Bluetooth to the tablet, to Carol, and you're good to go. So yes, you can do that. All right, and that wraps it up. That was my review of Carol. It's an amazing bike that significantly reduces the time it takes for you to get in a good workout. 8 minutes and 40 seconds is all it takes 3 times a week. That's 26 minutes of total time investment to get fitter from a cardiovascular and cardiorespiratory perspective, to lower your blood pressure, lower your blood sugar, increase your good cholesterol, HDL, decrease your triglycerides, and do all of the things that you typically would get with longer workouts that make you sweat significantly more, that cause you to or force you to take a shower, get a change of clothes, invest significantly more time, all of that compressed into a super intense but reduced exertion training that takes less than 9 minutes. And that's really the key of Carol. What you're basically paying for when you get Carol is the ability to work out in such a compressed time frame, to do it in less than 9 minutes and only 3 times a week, and you get the same benefits as going for a 45 minute run 5 times a week. That's a significant time saving, and it makes it also much, much more likely to do it every day, or at least 3 times a week. Because if you think about it, when you get on Carol, you know it's only 40 seconds of real work. There is no excuse why you can't do that. Everyone can put in 20 seconds, rest a little bit, and put in another 20 seconds. You can do that. You are mentally strong enough to do it again and again and again. And that increases the likelihood of actually sticking with that workout, making it part of your routine, making it part of your lifestyle. And only if you do that, you're gonna reap the long-term benefits. Because if you start any workout routine and in a month or 2 months, you quit it and you go back to be, you know, lazy and sedentary and all of that, you haven't won anything. But with Carol, knowing that 3 times a week, less than 9 minutes, you're not gonna sweat much or not at all, and it's only 2 times 20 seconds of actual work, you will be able to keep doing that hopefully for the rest of your life. And as you get fitter, you might then explore other types of workouts to complement your Carol routine, because you're fitter. You can do stuff, you know, you can go for longer walks, you can suddenly start doing CrossFit because you can handle it, you're fit enough. And that's really what Carol is all about, and that's why I like that bike so much. Even though I've been doing CrossFit very intensively, 5 times a week for a couple of years, I still use Carol to improve my fitness. And if you remember the numbers from before, 28% improvement in VO2 max, 37% improvement of peak power, all of that in only 2 years. And at that point 2 years ago, I was already relatively fit, and now I'm even fitter. So the older I get, the fitter I become. And that's really the ultimate goal, to beat the inflation that is aging. And if I can do it, you can do it. So if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Until next time.